My name is Timo Honkela. I'm working as a professor at the University of Helsinki on matters related to digital humanities and the application of artificial intelligence. And here I would like to view some potential directions of how computing will change in the future. Namely, computing like already famous characters like Alan Turing created the formal basis for how computing is being viewed and being applied and implemented. And if Alan Turing was both a theoretical but also practical character in this, I would like to specifically refer to John von Neumann, who created in a sense the architecture of computers already quite some time ago, which means that actually the computers have been the same for very many decades, and the architecture, the computational architecture, the computers that we are nowadays using, even the most advanced ones, are still the same as they used to be already more than 50 years ago. And the reason why I'm paying attention to this matter is the following. The architecture makes a division between the memory of the computer or the computing system and the processes that reason over the data and what is in the memory. And this is strongly different from what we humans have in our cognitive capacities. So when we experience something, that directly influences what is our mental content, so to say. The cognitive processes are intertwined in such a way that both the memory and our experiences, our reasoning, are interrelated in a strong way, whereas traditional von Neumann architecture computer is such that the memories are located in the computer in such a way that they are found based on the address. So you are having the address where you may have something like something related to the buildings in one place, and just in the next location you may have something related to agriculture, etc., etc. So there's no association between the contents, and that means that the systems, the computational systems, the programs that we build using these von Neumann architectures, means that the system doesn't actually have any essential understanding in a human way about the processes and the contents. And that means that architectures which are based on neural networks like Kohnen's self-organizing maps are such that they simulate the human processes. But the problem is that those neural networks and those algorithms need to be implemented in von Neumann architecture basis, and that's quite unoptimal. So my prediction or even hope for the future is that we would be able to build computers where the associative memory is actually the basic component in the architecture of computational systems. And if we think about what is the practical consequence of the current situation and this potential future situation, when we nowadays, we as humans, we encounter something in the world, we can immediately position this experience, what we have at hand, to our previous memories and can have a kind of understanding what is it all about. And the computers need to make a quite complicated reasoning process, whatever pattern recognition or reasoning before entering to the phase that this computational system can really reason in a reasonable way. And this difference between humans and computers is remarkable, and that's a motivation to consider that the future of computing can be actually quite different. And that means that we would give up the von Neumann architecture that is being used in practice in all computers nowadays and replace it with a new architecture, which of course requires huge amount of work. But my humble suggestion is that it actually makes sense to do it. It takes dozens of years, because all our computers that need to be replaced with the new ones, so we of course understand that will be a kind of huge effort. But thank you for following this idea, and I hope that this leads into future discussion. Thank you.